हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट. वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द एजुकेशन. वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द क्वालिटी ऑफ पॉपुलेशन व्हिच इज ऑन द पेज नंबर 20 ऑफ योर टेक्स्ट बुक्स. सो इन क्वालिटी ऑफ द पॉपुलेशन इम्पॉर्टेंट आस्पेक्ट दैट इज एजुकेशन दैट वी हैव बीन डिस्कसिंग फ्रॉम द यस्टरडे. ओके, सो Sakal's we compare the Sakal's education. We compare Sakal's and another of that same village, Vilas. One of them invested in the education. Their parents invested in the education and medical care. And another Vilas, he engaged, he started work of his mother because of not having the investment in education and health. Means quality of population, if we want to increase the quality of population, then we have to be focused on the education that we are going to discuss. Okay, students, so there is provision made for There is provision made for what? There is provision for made for providing the universal access, retention and quality in elementary education. Means all children, school going children, they require quality education. All school-going children require quality education, especially elementary education or basic education, with the special emphasis on the girl. Even though we discussed yesterday in previous lecture that parents, especially in rural, now it is not there, but still there is a stigma in place of the parents that they wanted to invest their resources, money resources, in their male children instead of girl children. Nowadays in urban areas, parents, they are investing for the both male and female children. But still in the rural area, it happened. Okay. So there is also establishment of PACE, setting the schools in Navodaya. Before to that, we are going to discuss here graph 2.1 literacy rate in India. With this graph, this graph is depicting literacy rate in India. Here in horizontal line given years and vertical line given percentage of the literacy. So it started from the 1951 and three colors are indicated in this bar: red color, blue color and faint yellow color. Red color it indicating here, red color it indicating here what percentage of male in of literacy rate, and yellow color, faint yellow color, represent or indicate or depicting the percentage of literacy rate of the female, and one column that is blue color, it is this blue color indicates total rate including male and female total literacy rate. So these three columns with different color showing literacy rate in India. Even human being is it is called the human being is positive asset. Positive asset, asset sampatti. Positive asset and precious national resource. Human being also called, that is why, because of having the positive asset, ह्यूमन बींग इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड द और इट इज़ कंसिडर प्रीशियस नेशनल रिसोर्स विच नीड्स टू बी चेरिश मीन्स विच नीड्स टू बी डेवलप और हैव टू बी नीड इन द इन्वेस्टमेंट इन एजुकेशन टू डेवलप दिस ह्यूमन रिसोर्स एंड चेरिश नर्चर एंड डेवलप विद द टेंडरनेस एंड केयर मीन्स न्यूट्रिशनल स्टेटस वुड बी देयर फॉर अर्ली चाइल्डहुड इवन मेडिकल फैसिलिटीज हैव टू बी अवेलेबल फॉर फॉर्मेशन ऑफ दिस असेट ह्यूमन रिसोर्स सो कैटलिस्ट एक्शन ऑफ एजुकेशन इन दिस कॉम्प्लेक्स एंड डायनेमिक ग्रोथ मीन्स दिस दिस इज द कॉम्प्लेक्स एंड डायनेमिक ग्रोथ ऑफ द ह्यूमन रिसोर्स ऑफ द पीपल विच कन्वर्ट इन टू द ह्यूमन रिसोर्स एंड एजुकेशन हियर वर्क एज अ कैटलिस्ट एक्शन कैटलिस्ट मीन्स यू माइट हैव लर्न कैटलिस्ट इन केमिस्ट्री सो हियर कैटलिस्ट वर्क एज अ वर्क हियर एज सॉरी एजुकेशन वर्क एज अ कैटलिस्ट एंड दैट इज वाई फ्रॉम अर्ली चाइल्डहुड गेटिंग एजुकेशन पीपल डेवलप एज अ ह्यूमन रिसोर्स विच इज़ वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट और प्रीशियस रिसोर्स ऑफ द कंट्री देन देर इज डायनेमिक ग्रोथ डायनेमिक मीन्स कंटिन्यूसली ग्रोथ टेकन प्लेस ऑफ दिस थ्रू द एजुकेशन ऑफ दिस ह्यूमन रिसोर्स एंड नीड्स टू बी प्लान meticulously and executed with a great sensitivity and this is the graph which we have seen from 1951 to 2011 in 1951 there was total percentage of literacy which indicate the blue color that was only 30% including male and women And if we discuss it separately of male and female, so there was only 20% of the male literacy rate in 1951. And in same year, female literacy rate that was very, very less and only 10%. Then after every 10 year, through the census, all this information collect through the survey. So here given the figures of 1961, 71, 1981, 1991, 2001, then 2004, and 2011. So here in 2011, total literacy rate that went above 70. Total literacy rate in 2011 that went above 70 and if we consider about the male literacy rate in 2011 that becomes more than 80 that went more than 80 which one was only 20 in 1951 and if we consider about the female literacy rate in 2011 that went near about the 65% which one was very less in 1951 that was only 10 so this is about the graph 2.1 about the literacy rate how this literacy rate male female and including male and female together how that increased from 1951 to 2011 and this is this increasing in ascending order after every 10 years okay so here there is provision for providing the universal access for the providing universal access for the assess retention and quality of elementary education with the special emphasis on girl means quality of elementary education that should be important and all school going children including specially female children they have to be assessed. Assess means they have to be reached in the school and government taking continuously efforts as you know Sarv Shiksha Abhiyan which program runs by the central government with the help of local that is ZP body they give special attention through this program on the elementary education especially for the female children and for this there is also an establishment of the pace setting of the schools pace means here speed taken place for establishing the school especially residential schooling because in rural areas generally parents send their children female children girl children to the school if that education is available in their own village and they are not ready generally to send the nearest town for getting the education this is the fact and for this purpose for increasing the girls percentage in education government established government establishment of the pace setting schools like Navoday Vidyalay in each district government program was there is there that in each district there should be the Navoday Vidyalay and government establish this school in each district even though vocational streams also have been developed in equip large number of high school students with the occupation related knowledge and skill means with the education government introduced some vocational subject with the school education especially in the higher education means middle 8 9 10 like this occupation related knowledge and skill for getting the idea or knowledge about the skills and professional knowledge about particular subject so the plan outlay on the education has increased from rupees 151 crore in the first plan that was 3766.90 crore in the 11th plan you know the what we say 5-year plan means planning for example in our family financial planning it is done our through our parents for yearly for monthly in the same way government of India even state government they makes their planning yearly as well as 5-year in this they their insight is that what should be the income media for income mediums for the government and where government have to be spend money or where have means all income and expenditure what would be the income of the country or government and what would be the expenditure this is called the financial financial expenditure income and expenditure that is in short it is called the 5-year plan so in 1951 this this one was only 151 crore that was the budget in first 5-year plan and if we talk about the 11th 5-year plan that budget increased and went that is 3766.90 crore means see how the difference is there on the expenditure and income so the expenditure on the education as percentage of GDP rose even percentage expenditure of the expenditure on the education that also increased in increase education. They gave priority or provision for increasing the expenditure on education, and that is why we have just seen above illiteracy rate increase as comparing to the 1951 till 2011. It is ascending order, growth is taken place. Okay, so here as the percentage of GDP rose, GDP means gross domestic product, means production of all three sectors, primary, secondary, tertiary, within a particular year, that is called the GDP. GDP also rose from 0.64% in 1951-52. GDP kitna tha 51-52 mein? That was only 0.64%, means that was not at least 1% also. But if we consider about the 2011-12, it went 3.11%. Now because of COVID situation, this GDP that went in the minus, but as comparing to the 1951-52, that was not even 1%, but 2011-12 that went to 3.11%, and now it is down, that became minus. Okay, so this is about the page number 21 which we have discussed. Here some of the question is there through the through this map, just we have seen 2.1. so what are the question here? Has the literacy rate of the population increased since 1951? Just we have discussed from since 1951, literacy rate is in increasing order. Total literacy rate, even male and female literacy rate, they are increasing continuously, consistently from 1951. Okay, in which year India has highest literacy rate? Highest literacy rate ye graph mein jo diye hai, to उस हिसाब से ईयर वाइज हाईएस्ट लिटरेसी रेट कब हुआ है? दैट वाज इन द 2011, फ्रॉम 1951 टू 2011 दिस ग्राफ इज शोइंग हियर, डिपेक्टिंग हियर, एंड फ्रॉम दिस लिटरेसी रेट बिकेम हाईएस्ट इन इंडिया इन 2011. ओके, थर्ड वन, व्हाई लिटरेसी रेट इज हाई अमंग द मेल of India? Literacy rate यदि male female से compare करते हैं तो male का ज़्यादा होता है, तो that also we have just discussed that parents gives priority or they wanted to invest money in education for their male children, and they consider female children education is secondary. उनको लगता है कि बच्ची बड़ी होने के बाद उसको शादी करके दूसरे के घर ही जाना है. दैट वॉज द प्रिजुडाइज इन द माइंड, बट नाउ दिस सिनेरियो चेंज, दे स्टार्टेड थिंकिंग डिफरेंटली नाउ, एंड इवन नाउ अ डेज गर्ल्स दे आर टेकिंग डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ एजुकेशन जस्ट लाइक मेल चिल्ड्रेन, एंड दे आर वर्किंग इन डिफरेंट फील्ड. ओके, सो दिस इज थर्ड वन. फोर्थ इज वॉट? Why are women less educated than the men? So answer is same, because they do not get the opportunity for higher education. They wanted to invest money only for the male children. They consider secondary for the investment. Okay, how would you calculate the literacy rate in India? लिटरेसी रेट इंडिया का कैसे कैलकुलेट किया जाता है? थ्रू द सेंसस, आफ्टर एवरी 10 ईयर्स सेंसस मीन्स पॉपुलेशन काउंटिंग इट इज डन थ्रू द सर्वे. ओके, व्हाट इज योर प्रोजेक्शन अबाउट द इंडियाज लिटरेसी रेट इन 2020? 2020 इट इज गोइंग एंड नाउ लिटरेसी रेट इट इज much higher in India, and if we consider about the Kerala, it is much more even comparing to the other state. So come to, this is about the page number 21 of your textbooks, and then come to the page number 22. This one was 21. Okay, come to the page number 22 of your textbook. So this is activity. This is the activity. What is given here? Count the number of boys and girls studying in your school or in your neighboring co-education school. Co-education means where both these male and female children goes in the school. They are because now it is concept, but before to that, some educational institutions, they were giving, they were set up for only girls, especially girls, even girls colleges, girls schools. Now co-education, it is very common. Okay, the study of difference, if any, and explain for the reason the classroom. This is one of the activity, and come then come to the down, that literacy rate have increase from 80% in 1951 to 74% in 2010 and 11 तक कितना इंक्रीज हुआ है फ्रॉम 18% टू 74%. सो लिटरेसी इज नॉट ओनली राइट, इट इज ऑल्सो नीडेड इफ द सिटीजन्स आर टू परफॉर्म देयर duties and enjoy their rights properly. However, vast difference is noticed across the different section of the population. Means different state, different sections of the population, they have their different literacy rate. All states, they are not equally developed for the education or we have seen Bihar's literacy rate is much less comparing to the other state, and highest literacy rate of the Kerala. I mean, between different states, they have their different literacy rate. They are not having the equal literacy rate. So here, literacy among the male is nearly 16.6% higher than the female. Female से literacy percentage जो है males का वो ज़्यादा है, और कितना ज़्यादा है, how much it is more, 16.6% higher than the female, and it is about 16.1% higher in the urban areas. Then again, percentage, it is not same in urban and rural areas. Rural areas percentage of the literacy, that is less comparing to the urban area, and even girls also, girls percentage for the literacy rate is less in rural comparing to the urban area. So here literacy rate vary from 93.9 in the Kerala to 63 in Bihar. Means Bihar's literacy rate is only 63% and Kerala 93.99, means near about 94. Okay, this figure may change more or less. The primary school system has expanded to over 7.68 lakh in 2004 and 2005. Means primary schooling system, that is expanded, especially in the 2004 and 2005. Unfortunately, this huge expansion of school has been diluted by the poor quality of schooling and high drop out rate. Now in 2004-05, schooling 60 expanded. But what happened? Negative aspect is what? Unfortunately, this huge expansion taken place in a large scale schools are established for giving the elementary education, but their quality became low or high. There is high dropout rates, means admit to hote, register to hote school record mein, but they do not go to the school. Okay, so here sir, what thing we are considering here? Primary school has expanded. We were talking about this. So, to over 7.68 lakh related to the 2004 and 2005. But their quality becomes low and dropout also became high. So, Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan is the significant step towards the providing elementary education to all children in the age group of 6 to 14 years by 2010. So, on this solution, government, central government, they given solution for this quality and dropout. They introduce program, central government, that is Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan for the elementary education. And what is the age group for this program, Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan? Age group is from 6 to 14 years. And this program was by 2010, but now it is expanding. Now, even though today, means 2020 is going on, but still that program is continuous. So, it is bound initiative of the central government in the partnership with the state. Means this program, Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan program, it is started by whom? Central government with the help of local institutions, in the partnership with state, means central and state both collaboration is there for this Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan for improving status and giving special facilities to the children, especially poor children, girl children, for attending the school, for increasing the ratio for the literacy rate. Okay, here in partnership, means this program, it is run by the partnership with state government, initiative of whose? Central government. And local government and community for achieving the goal of universalization of elementary education. So local bodies, for example ZP, Jilla Parishad, and community also, they work with this in this program with the government, state and central government, for successing this elementary universalization of the elementary education. Along with it, bridge courses and back to school camp have been initiated to increase the enrollment in elementary education. Means some other supportive programs included in this for increasing the enrollment, increasing enrollment in the school, or dropout percentage have to be means that should be less. So midday meal scheme has been implemented, one of the important programs, because specially it is motivation for the poor children, poor parents, for sending their children wards to the school, especially girls and poor children. So So in through this program, government introduced midday meal scheme. Means they get you are very familiar for government school and government granted school. Children gets the midday meal. That is khichdi is very popular. As you means you keep generally you keep tiffin with you, but these children, those who are admitted in the government school or government granted school, there is no need for carrying tiffin with them. They get this nutritious food, or popularly it is known as khichdi, through this and that is called the midday meal. Means this is the motivation for enrollment, increasing enrollment or coming the children in the school for increasing the literacy rate. Okay, so everyone clear about what is midday meal and where they introduce, what is goal or motivation, all these things we have cleared here. Okay, so implementation to the encourage attendance increase hona chahiye, and retention of children. रिटेंशन मीन्स वो स्कूल में एडमिट है लेकिन रजिस्टर है लेकिन वो स्कूल में नहीं जाते, दैट इज़ कॉल्ड द रिटेंशन. एंड इम्प्रूव देयर न्यूट्रिशनल स्टेटस, और न्यूट्रिशनल स्टेटस भी इम्प्रूव होना चाहिए, इसीलिए मिड डे मील गवर्नमेंट इंट्रोड्यूस, बिकॉज पुअर पेरेंट दे डू नॉट अफोर्ड चिल्ड्रन न्यूट्रिशियस फूड, एंड दिस इज द मोटिवेशन फॉर सेंडिंग चिल्ड्रन to the school, that they are children getting the nutritious food in school. This is the motivation for increasing the ratio, attendance ratio. And this policy could add to the literate population of India, and that is why if we compare about from 1951 to 2010, consistently, literacy rate is increasing order, and all these are the motivation through this Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan, and now day by day it is in increasing. Okay, so this is about the midday meal, and here given about the 11th plan. 11th plan means 5-year plan. After every 5 year, government makes the financial planning of the income of 5 years and income expenditure on where have to expend for 5 year income and expenditure. That is called the planning. So 11th plan, endeavor to increase the enrollment in higher education. 11th प्लान में प्रायोरिटी या फोकस किसको दिया है कि हायर एजुकेशन जो है उसका इंक्रीज होना चाहिए, इंक्रीज द एनरोलमेंट इन हायर एजुकेशन ऑफ द 18 to 23 ईयर्स ग्रुप. हायर एजुकेशन जो लेने वाले स्टूडेंट होते हैं दे आर बिलोंगिंग टू द 18 to 23 ईयर्स मीन्स ग्रेजुएशन. Okay, so in here in of this group 15% by 2011 and 12. So because of encouragement, all this encouragement, higher education percentage of 18 to 23 years children, that increase 15% by which year? 2011 and 12. Before to that percentage was very less of higher education. Is all these are the strategy of the government for increasing human capital. The strategy focuses on increasing assess quality, adoption and state specific curriculum modification, vocationalization, and the networking on the use of information technology. Means whatever day-to-day need, different subjects for the or vocational education, they give priority on in this higher education. Nowadays, now recently Prime Minister मोदी जी इंट्रोड्यूस्ड, गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया इंट्रोड्यूस्ड न्यू फाइनेंशियल प्लानिंग फ्रॉम द नेक्स्ट ईयर. सो ऑल दिस फॉर ब्रिंगिंग द चेंजेस और इम्प्रूवमेंट. ओके, एंड वॉट एवर सब्जेक्ट्स आर रिलेटेड टू द डेवलपमेंट और डे टू डे लाइफ, फॉर एग्जाम्पल आई टी, इट इज़ न्यू सब्जेक्ट एंड डिफरेंट मीन्स रिवोल्यूशन टेकन प्लेस इन दिस आई टी. सो दिस टेक्नोलॉजी और मीन्स दे डेवलप और दे गिव्स प्रायोरिटी, मॉडिफिकेशन टेकन टेक्स प्लेस एंड वोकेशनलाइजेशन मीन्स पेरेंट्स हैव सॉरी चिल्ड्रेन हैव टू लर्न द वोकेशनल सब्जेक्ट फॉर गेटिंग बेटर नॉलेज स्किल फॉर देयर फ्यूचर लाइफ इफ दे वॉन्टेड टू इन्वॉल्व इन द सेल्फ एम्प्लॉयमेंट फॉर जनरेटिंग सेल्फ एम्प्लॉयमेंट और वर्किंग इन द इंडस्ट्री. सम वोकेशनल एजुकेशन ऑल्सो दे गेट्स थ्रू दिस हायर एजुकेशन. ओवर द पास्ट 50 years, ओवर द पास्ट 50 years देर हैज़ बीन सिग्निफिकेंट ग्रोथ इन द नंबर ऑफ यूनिवर्सिटीज, नंबर ऑफ मीन्स यूनिवर्सिटी दे वेर वेरी लिमिटेड, बट नाउअडेज मोर मीन्स डिफरेंट यूनिवर्सिटीज इन डिफरेंट एरियाज सेटअप मीन्स ग्रोथ टेकन प्लेस ऑफ द यूनिवर्सिटीज, नंबर ऑफ यूनिवर्सिटीज विच गिव्स द हायर एजुकेशन दे देर नंबर इंक्रीज्ड. ओके, सो हियर एंड दिस ग्रोथ टेकन प्लेस ओवर 50 years, देर हैज़ बीन सिग्निफिकेंट ग्रोथ इन नंबर ऑफ यूनिवर्सिटीज एज वेल एज स्पेशलाइज्ड एरियाज. When we were studying at that time, very limited subjects were there for the graduation. But if we talk today, different they have different subjects in the graduation in science, B.Sc. The different subjects are there, engineering side, different subjects or different specializations are there. Okay, so here. Over the past 50 years, there has been significant growth of the number of universities. Number of universities, institution, higher learning institution increase in specialized area. Let us read about the table to see increase in number of colleges, universities. Means table is given on this page number 22. Just we have discussed that consistently. Institutions which gives the higher education, they are increasing. So table it is showing here from 1950-51 to 2011 and 12. Number of college in 1950-51 there were only 750 colleges were there, and now in 2011 and 12, and again this is figure given only about 2011 and 12. Now again these are increase, and this is about 31,324. Even though if we talk about the universities, so in 1951 only 30 universities were there, and till 2011-12 this quantity increased, that came 611. Even student quantity, if the universities are increased, colleges are increased, automatically students also increase from 1950-51 to 2011-12. In 2050-51 their quantity, number of students were 263,000, but it went much more. Figure is not given, but it is much more. Even teachers automatically increase as per the universities, as per the colleges, and teachers, they were only means higher colleges, means colleges teachers, they were only 24,000, and now this figure is also increased. Okay, student, so here is 22 page number which we have discussed here. Okay, good day student.